Right, so let's continue our discussion. So after tapping on that expand list, and in this lecture, let's see how to long press and open a submenu out of it. Okay, so let's say I clicked on views and then we tapped on expandable list. And now let's click on this custom adapter, and then I will long press on these people names. Okay, when I long press like this, some submenu like this will be opened, right? Now we have to validate if this is displayed or not by long pressing on it. So this is also gesture. Okay, so you don't have this in any web cases, like long press on specific element and wait to display submenu. And that also we will achieve with the help of this touch action. Okay, so let's see how do we do that. So let me go back, and here I have to click on a custom adapter, right? I'm pretty sure that even that have same X path as at the rate text is equals to custom adapter, but I would quickly take a screenshot to confirm that. So if you see any failure, put thread dot sleep, because our system have just 8 GB RAM like that, and we are opening emulator, Eclipse, all other tools, right? So it slows down and it takes it will be a little slow to navigate each and every page, and you may see some timeout issues. If that is the case, for temporary practice purpose, use thread dot sleep and continue. Okay, so just for your information, custom adapter, you see that text is again present, and we can use this XPath just like how we have used here. Alright, so here we are just clicking on this, we are not tapping anything. You can do tapping as well, but for now let's click. Our main goal here is to reach that last page and see the functionality of long press. That's the main goal of this lecture. So let's not waste time here on clicking on this custom adapter and all. Perfect. So this way I'll click. Okay, so what next? So it clicks on that, and now I have to long press. Okay, so let's see how can we do that again. So if you want to do any mobile gesture, you have to depend upon this touch action object. It's again very simple, T dot. So what you have to do now, you have to long press on an element. So long press, and you see that again, just like tap, you have long press options here. Okay, so select this, and what you have to do now, just follow the same format of this. Now long press options is an argument which is expecting here, isn't it? So long press options dot, you won't get any suggestion now because you have not imported a package. So here also first we did not get anything, right? So first let's import a package. As I said again, how do you know that you have to write this inside? If you just say t dot long press, you will understand. T dot long press, you see that long press options. Okay, so that itself will give you. So you need to just use the methods present in this long press options class. So let's go and import that package. As I said, the Eclipse will not give you that. Let's copy the same of the previous step, but here instead of tap options, touch dot, and you see long press options. Okay, and say dot long press options. Perfect, and error is gone. So now when you say dot, and now you tell on which element I want to long press. So earlier, on which element you want to tap, that methods are all present in tap options class. And now on which element I want to long press, that methods are all present in this long press options with element. You know, right? Basically you have to say element of web element inside this. to make it work. So this web element is nothing but the object of that people names. Let's go and grab that people names object. This is the one, and let me take the screenshot of it. Okay, so people names, I can use the class name. Yeah, good. We all have text attributes to make our lives easy here. All right, so I can use everything here. I can put, and on the text place, it's a people names, right? So let's go and carefully replace it. And web element, you can say PN, people names, something like that. Okay, so this PN will go inside this. That's it. Okay, so now you clearly told that long press on this element. Fine. Dot. So how many seconds you have to long press? If you simply long press, the menu may not be displayed. Okay, if you are a typical Android user, see, you have to at least long press for 2 seconds or one and a half second to come to pop up to display. If you simply long press and leave, it won't come. You have to hold this and then only this pop up comes. You see that? Now I long pressed. I did not get. But if I hold on this with long press and then it displays. So here we have to tell long press on this element for how much duration. Just say dot, you will say with duration. You see that all the actions we are able to concatenate with this long press options class methods. Okay, so that's where, you know, this whole touch action come into handy. And now this makes sense, right? With element. So how many seconds you have to give this with duration. So let's say 2 seconds is what ideal time to play around this. So you can give the duration of seconds 2. Again, there is no import for this, unfortunately. So you have to again import this seconds package here. It's a Java. This is nowhere related to Appium. Okay, so off seconds is something. We have a package from Java time duration of seconds. I got it this from Google. Okay, this is not in top of my head. So in Java packages, you have time where you can provide that in of seconds. All right, right. Okay, so we have long pressing on element for 2 seconds. After you do for a 2 seconds, then technically what you do on mobile, you long press for 2 seconds and you really release that, right? You remove your button to release that long press. Okay, let's go and say dot. 1 sec. So make sure all 1, 2 open, 2 closed, and 2 brackets open, 2 brackets closed. Right, so we are closing this long press. We are done. After that, let's release this whole set, release. Okay, so this argument, whatever going inside, will long press and hold for 2 seconds. And once this is done, we are wrapping up this entire long press method with the T dot, and then we are releasing it. Releasing that, what is the last step? I clearly told that if there is any touch action concept, you have to mandatorily end with perform, so that it will execute all these steps in a sequence. Okay, right. So this is how you can long press and open a submenu using touch actions. Okay, so now it look little familiar, right? Compared to previous thing. So like this, if you do 1 or 2 exercises, you will definitely make this look, this touch actions definitely looks very simple, right? So this is self-explanatory. now. Okay, so what happens when this menu open? Let me go and grab the screenshot again. Where is the UI automate? Just to make sure if the screen is displaying. Okay, so sample menu, sample action, all these are displaying, right? Okay, resource ID, we have Android ID title. Let's check if this is displayed. If this is displayed, our test is passed. Okay, so that's all you need to do here. Let me put some sleep because it may quickly verify that. We still do that, but just to make sure our step scripts will not break due to performance issues. Right, so let's run this test and see how it goes. Okay. Oh, make sure that your XPath is like this. I hope you already recognize this. And to just make sure no synchronization errors happening, let's also put an implicit timeout. Okay, so driver dot, we have done this in our previous lecture. Manage dot, start window, implicit wait, no, sorry. Manage dot timeout, I guess, let's see. Yeah, timeout start. Implicit wait time unit dot seconds, and let's say 10 seconds is the base number what we can target. Okay, so swap arguments, perfect. Now it's all set. So now we are actually putting implicit wait so that if object is not displayed, it will wait at least 10 seconds before test breaks, so that you can avoid all these thread slips. But sometimes if your application is too slow, then you might use this. But I think here in our case, it's not required. Let's run this test and see how it goes. So I will attach the script to download with this lecture. Download this code and make sure you import all these packages into your test so that you can smoothly work with long press and tapping stuff. Let me go back and start this. You see that execution started, it clicked on views, it clicked on expandable list, custom adapter, it long clicked on people names, and you see that submenu is displayed and it written 200 success, value is true. Okay, so that's what we need here. Okay, you see that output is also displayed as true. That means submenu is displayed. That's it. So that's how you can long press on element and wait for few seconds and then release the long press and execute that using perform method. After that, you can put validation on your submenu. Okay, so this is how touch action will help you to concatenate your actions. So in our earlier, we are just tapping on element. That's it. We are not long pressing or we are not releasing anything. So that's why it looks simple. So this is like multiple actions. The only thing you need to remember here, packages. For element, you need to import this package. For tap option, this. And for long press option, this. Now, you might be wondering like how I came to know about all this. Let me show you. Yeah, so when I just hit Appium long press options, then if I go and read their API, so there they have given information that what they have added long press options. You see that? And it's little messy to read this documentation, but yes, I have done hard work to understand all this and that make your work easy. And here where I understood like what is the package we need to import. Ivo.appium.java client touch. Okay, so this is the package which we need to know. And there is also one practice exercise, one sample test they have given. just to show us how this touch action works, I have went through it, and here is where you will find all these import packages. You see that element option. Okay, some people are very curious to see that how I will come to know like this, if there are any existing packages. Yes, I told you, but if you want to explore on your own, everything will be on their official documentation of this Appium/Java Client. And here there are some examples they have shared with us, so which made me to analyze this with this document, and then I understood how this import statements work, and then I tried in my local and it worked. Okay, so that's how I learned. And for you, you need not worry about all this, just follow my lecture and you will understand how to do all this. All right, so that's pretty much about long pressing. We'll see in one more topic in our next lecture. Thank you guys.